You don't have to live in the world of rigging like we do to find yourself needing a ratchet strap. One thing that has become obvious to us though is that even though there's a lot of people that use ratchet straps, many do not actually know how to use them correctly. Now, if you've ever taken a ratchet strap that was in use by somebody else and you found the webbing tangled up on the spool and you couldn't use it or it was tied in a knot, then you know what I mean. So the goal of this video is to quickly talk about what ratchet straps are, how they are used correctly, and what sizes and fittings are commonly available. So here's a quick demonstration on how to use a basic ratchet strap. So once you have one end connected, you can take your ratchet strap and thread it through the spool, kind of go in the front and simply out the back. And then you're gonna pull this end hand tight. So you have a little bit of tension on both ends of the ratchet strap. So I've now pulled it hand tight. So I'm gonna come over here on this side and start working the ratchet strap with a little bit of tension, it starts to wind onto the spool. And I can go about as tight as I want. Keep in mind that however much you load this, you're putting that amount of pressure on your anchor points as well. So in the event that you put your ratchet strap to the test, let's say you have to slam on your brakes, you're gonna stress not just the ratchet strap, but also your anchor point. So tight, but not too tight. So I'll give this one last torque, feels pretty good. Now in the event that I need to release this and re-rig it, or maybe I arrive at my destination, I'm ready to take it apart, I'm simply gonna pull on this release mechanism, lift and open the handle. The spring releases on the inside, and now I can just pull the ratchet strap, release the tension, unhook my hooks, and I'm good to go. So the process for setting up a larger ratchet strap is really the same. You're gonna take the dead end, thread it through, and pull it back until it's hand tight. So we have this one pre-rigged really just to demonstrate scale, to show you how a 2-inch ratchet strap is quite a bit larger than a 1-inch. You have a lot more room for your hand, much bigger handle, much bigger everything. This one in particular has twisted hooks on the end, not the most popular configuration, but we did mention that there's a lot of different options for end fittings. We wanted to show these to you. So again, now that I have it hand tight, I'm gonna start to ratchet. It starts to wind up and get tight pretty quick in this short span. I'll go until I think it's good. It is now locked into place. Again, to release it, I'm gonna grab on this mechanism, pull up, open the handle until I hear the pop, and it's now loose. I can remove my hooks, uninstall the ratchet strap, and we're done. We stock ratchet straps in 1, 2, 3, and even 4-inch widths. The 1-inch size is generally 15 or 16 feet in length and is great for general light duty use. Rated at 1,000 pounds and good for securing motorcycles, ATVs, and other small equipment in pickup or utility trailer beds. More than one ratchet strap may be required for both rating and load stability purposes. The 2-inch size is really the go-to size for most contractors securing items on a flatbed, trailer, or a similar setup. Generally, they are 27 or 30 feet in length, although different lengths can be had, and we do make custom ratchet straps if you need that. The standard rating on a 2-inch ratchet strap is going to be 3,335 pounds, which is your working load limit. The most common fittings that you're gonna find are wire hooks, which are also known as J hooks, and flat hooks. So on the table in front of me, this example, which is a 3-inch ratchet strap, this is a J hook, and this one in front of me right here is a flat hook. As I mentioned, other fittings are also available, such as a sewn loop, or even a twisted snap hook, and there's other options as well. Now, when you get into larger applications, you might need a bigger ratchet strap. So to my left here is a 3-inch ratchet strap, and on the right is a 4-inch. One of the quick things to point out is the ratchet itself and the handle. You can see the size and scale on a 2-inch ratchet strap. When you compare that to a 3-inch and even a 4-inch, everything gets bigger. So the webbing is wider, the ratchet mechanism itself is a lot bigger, the hooks are also bigger. So that's something to think about. Now on a 3-inch ratchet strap, when you have two lines of tracer running through the webbing, that's going to be rated at 5,500 pounds. And on a 4-inch ratchet strap, if you have two lines running through, it's going to be rated at 6,600. This particular one gets the lower rating because it only has one tracer line running through the middle. We don't stock a ton of these. Most everything we do is heavy duty, but it's something to pay attention to if you're in the market shopping for a ratchet strap. So before you order a larger ratchet strap, just assuming that bigger is better, make sure you allow for the extra size and bulk. So I referenced it earlier, but it's important to think about it. Again, they're bigger and heavier, so a little bit more to manage. Also, the size of the fittings could be a deal breaker depending upon your anchor points. You wanna make sure you can fit your wide J hook or your flat hook wherever you need it to go. Now, that said, What should really guide your purchasing decision is that you're buying product that's properly rated. So don't underpurchase because you want the convenience of a smaller ratchet strap, or overpurchase because you think bigger is better. Just make sure that you're buying stuff that is properly sized and rated for the load that you need to secure. A general rule of thumb is that the capacity of your ratchet straps used for tie down should equal or exceed the weight of the item that you're securing. So for example, if you have a 10,000 pound load that you need to secure, you need no less than 2 3-inch ratchet straps or 3 2-inch ratchet straps. So again, whatever the rating is combined for your straps needs to equal the weight of your load or exceed it. Something else to consider is protecting the webbing of your ratchet strap. So whether it's a lifting sling or a ratchet strap, we're talking about synthetic webbing, it can and will cut. So use wear pads where it makes sense, especially if you're wrapping around a sharp edge while under load. That's the quickest way to destroy the webbing. We offer many different types of wear pads, such as Velcro wear pads, which come apart and install easily, rubber slotted pads, plastic corner protectors, and more. In fact, we have a fully dedicated webpage for this, so check it out. Now, depending upon the load being secured, a ratchet strap may or may not be the right choice. For heavy duty applications or where sharp edges are a sure bet, use chains and binders instead. Now, if you plan to use a 2-inch ratchet strap or larger, make sure you can accommodate the larger end fittings. A traditional pickup bed has tie down points that are relatively small and hard to fit much into. One final point to make, ratchet straps such as what you see in front of me are not rated for overhead lifting. So in a scenario where you have multiple pick points and you're trying to level a load, don't use a ratchet strap. They are not rated for that. Hopefully now you have a better understanding of how ratchet straps are used, how the various sizes and fittings compare, and which ratchet strap might be best for your application. And this video might not have answered all of your questions, so please reach out to us if we can help you further. You can reach us via live chat at lifting.com, or visit the Contact Us page and fill out the form, or simply locate a branch near you. Thanks for watching. Please remember to like this video, leave a comment, and share the video. Help us grow the channel so we can keep putting out informative content like this in the future.